Hi everyone, my name is Karen Lang and I'm one of the authors of the book Become an App Inventor that you will be using to learn how to create really cool apps. Just to give you a little background about myself, I actually started as a programmer in my very early career and really loved it, but then I thought, I actually really love working with younger people to show them how cool programming is and coding is and what cool things you can do with it. So I went back and became a teacher. I actually taught for 20 years in different schools around the world. I taught in Venezuela, Hungary, England, but mostly I taught in the United States. And I mostly taught at the high school level. I just really enjoyed kind of bringing or showing young people the possibilities with technology, what you can build yourself, the possibilities with careers. It's just amazing and explosive, right? Everyone uses technology these days. One of the best parts of being a teacher was seeing young people the first time they got their program to work and kind of their eyes lighting up to say, hey, I got this to work and look what it can do and look what I can do. And hopefully you're going to have that experience yourself as you start to build some apps. So about the book itself, the education team at App Inventor, we worked with a team in Hong Kong to develop a three-year curriculum for fourth, fifth, and sixth graders. And that was piloted in many schools in Hong Kong and was quite successful. We decided then to kind of expand on the lessons that we had made for that curriculum to appeal more to a slightly older audience, so in the US, 6th, 7th, and 8th graders, so maybe like 10, 11th, and 12-year-olds. And we kind of went deeper with the curriculum and expanded on some of the apps that we decided to have the young people make. And then we decided, you know, let's try to reach even more young people and let's publish a book, which is the Become an App Inventor book. And so really you are some of these young people that we're hoping to reach, and we're happy that you're going to be using our book to learn how to make mobile apps. And you, again, hopefully you're going to see what power you have. You have great ideas, and you know, with just a little bit of knowledge here, you're going to be able to make really cool apps that can benefit yourself, your family, your community, and even potentially the world. So good luck with your camp here and learning how to make apps. And we actually are going to really look forward to see all the amazing things that you make. So keep in touch and have fun.
Greetings, everybody. My name is Salim Tezel. I'm one of the co-authors of the book Become an App Inventor, along with Karen Lang, my colleague Karen Lang. My background is actually I'm a teacher of 22 years. Before I started doing some work with App Inventor, I was a teacher of mathematics for about 22 years. I became interested in programming as a person in my 30s. When I was working on a mathematical puzzle called the Eight Queens Puzzle. You can see it right here on the left corner. It's basically the question where you have a regular 8x8 chessboard, and you have eight queens, and you know how queens can, you know, kill their rows, columns, diagonals. So the question was, how do you arrange eight queens on a chessboard so that none of the queens can kill each other? So it's a remarkably difficult problem. It has fascinated many people in the past, most notably Carl Friedrich Gauss, one of the most famous mathematicians who ever lived. What is interesting is Gauss was able to find some solutions to this, but he couldn't find all of the solutions. There are 92 solutions to this puzzle, and Gauss was able to get 84 of them. So when I learned how to do programming, and I programmed so that you know, all of these solutions can be one by one discovered, I was able to get all 92 of them, and I suddenly realized that I was able to somehow, with programming, give myself a power, a superpower that even Carl Gauss didn't have. And that really did something to my mind. I just never thought of in those terms before about programming and computers. So I decided to go to graduate school and studied programming a number of years. Now I work with the MIT App Inventor program project at MIT. Now, the book that you're going to be studying from, it was inspired by many different projects like Hong Kong projects that I believe Karen mentioned. But one of the most interesting things and inspiring things, at least for me in the book, is are the stories. We have included stories from all over the world by young programmers and how they got into programming and how you know, they had a, you know, maybe a community problem that they wanted to solve and how they used App Inventor to build an app that addresses their community problem. So I find these stories totally fascinating, you know, how the challenges were overcome and what was produced. As you know, Gitanjali Rao was generously, she wrote our foreword. She is one of the most luminous members of the App Inventor community. We are very proud of her. So we would like to thank you for using our book. We hope that it will guide you step by step so that you become convinced that programming is not difficult and it is very eye-opening and brain-opening. We believe you are in amazing hands. Your teachers are going to be able to help you and guide you in this process. And we are really, really looking forward to seeing what you produce for yourself and possibly for your communities. Now, as a final little pitch here, I want to alert you of a few annual events that we have. The first one is the Summer Appathon. The Appathon happens around July. And, you know, this is where all over the world, you know, many young people from 4 years old and actually adults all the way to 82 years old in the past have participated. They create basically apps that address some kind of a communal need. And you can find that on our website. And then I also want to alert you that during the year, every month, we have something called App of the Month. So you can produce an app and make a submission, and we will go through the submissions and announce, you know, the winners. And there are some fantastic, you know, projects that you could also actually spend some time going through and looking and studying them. Alrighty, we're proud of you. We look forward to what you're going to produce and all the best. Thanks for using the book. Take care.